Good afternoon, everyone. This is Nitin Jayakumar from RK University. On behalf of FDP activity, that is for FDP 301X, Mentoring Educators in Educational Technology, we will be providing you some information about the LMS systems and the types of systems which are widely used at different universities or places. And the topic for the FDP design activity, that is introduction to Moodle. But prior we go to in detail, first we have to understand what is LMS. There are different kind of management system tools available online or any other state. First one is CMS, that is content management system. Another one is LMS, that is called as learning management system. Both cannot be said as same parameters, but somehow they are same, because in both systems you will be managing some kind of contents in proper modules, proper sections, proper blocks. You will be assigning some discussion forums. It can be in terms of blog, it can be in terms for any PDF references, or it can be in terms for any video references also. But both cannot be used at same place. What I meant is both cannot be used for a single purpose. Because content management system, that is CMS, if I take it as an example of WordPress, that can be used as a resource center, such as like we use library in our college or at university. This is a storage of content that can be used at any time. But what about learning management system? In LMS, it is a software application in terms for e-learning, where you will be tracking, documenting, administrating and reporting and delivery of educational courses as well as the training programs. That means you will be uploading some contents in LMS. You will be tracking how the contents are used by other participants or peers and how they are performing at different grading stages of the contents. So it was assumed that the first introduction for the learning management system was done in 1990s. And obviously when there is digitalization and modernization in each field, there is so many areas that you will be seeing a mass flow of knowledge is taking place. And all these things has to be taken care while blended learning and flipped classroom techniques. So I'll be giving you a minute to think on various types of LMSs, that is learning management systems, that how many are they, or how they are different from each other, or what are the systems or what are the sections included in it. So take a minute and think over it. So I hope you might have thought about some of the LMSs, that what are available systems are there and how they are different or how they are used. Basically, as per my personal or professional experiences, I have used three kind of learning management systems. As you can see here, this is canvasinstructure.com. As you can see here, I have carried out three courses. This is your left menu bar where you can see dashboard, courses. If you see, click at the courses, you can set the calendars also. There are inbox messages, then comments, as the course is already over, so you will not be seeing any activities here. If you go for courses, you can see, if I click on particular course, design of machine element, you can see people, grades, discussion, files, syllabus. There are lots of components are there at this left bar. And as you can see, these are the participants of the courses. So this is Canvas. Now next we go to Edmodo. Edmodo is also same as that of Canvas, where both are dealing with the same thing. At this left bar, you can see the different subjects or courses delivered in different year. For example, if we go here, design of machine elements, you can see post, folders and members. If you click at the members, you will be seeing different members here, those who are registered in the course. As you can see, I am the owner and these are the students. At the folder section, you will be seeing different folders, videos, assignments, softbooks or handouts. These will be containing all different contents related to the course. So here it is folder, and if we go here at home, you will see different modules, discussions, grades, people, files. If you go for files, you will see, yes, you can see here, see assignments, handouts, syllabus. These are different folders. Now we go to Moodle. See, this is which we are going to learn, that how to create a course, how to enroll students, or how different things you can generate in that. This is the dashboard, calendar, private files. Site administration is one kind of the most important area where you will see that how to manage the course. As you can see, you go site administration, users, courses, grades, plugins, server, reports, development, everything is there. So we'll be basically dealing with how to use Moodle and how to get registered in Moodle, how to create a course, or how to manage different things. So we'll be dealing with that in the upcoming video. So thank you very much, and we'll be seeing you in the next video. Bye bye.